With its famous 1, 2, and 3-star ratings, the Michelin Guide is one of the most highly regarded authorities in the restaurant world. A global team of culinary spies are the ones that decide which restaurants get the accolades and which ones get downgraded or even ignored. They're known as the Michelin Guide Inspectors. A Michelin inspector's job is to eat at and review some 350 to 400 of the world's best food destinations every year. It's all done on the down low. Even top execs at Michelin don't know the inspectors' true identities.
So to speak, the only public face of the famously anonymous inspectors.
Gwendal works for Michelin, the French tire company that created the guide for motorists back in 1900. His team of inspectors travels the world, reviewing restaurants and eateries in 28 cities and countries for the iconic Red Book. About 3,000 restaurants worldwide currently boast at least one Michelin star. But exactly how many inspectors make up this elusive team isn't public knowledge.
Throughout the world, we have a real international team made of more than 15 different nationalities. Altogether, we speak more than 25 different languages.
They're generally on the road 3 weeks a month and dine out twice a day.
In their life as an inspector, they don't eat every meal every day in a star restaurant, but it can also balance their experience, and that's important.
Most inspectors come with 5 to 10 years of experience in the culinary or hospitality trade. New hires go through a rigorous 6-month training program, shadowing their senior inspectors. Sure, they'll eat a lot, but they'll also visit farms to see how produce is grown, study wines, and maybe even learn how butter is made. The training helps inspectors begin to develop their palate and eye for star-worthy restaurants, while learning to write about food from both a technical and emotional standpoint.
An inspector is really confirmed after 3 years on the field as an inspector. And 3 years, that means roughly 1,000 meals.
When inspectors head out into the field each year, they have a database of restaurants to visit and review. But sometimes the best spots are found the old-fashioned way, by talking to locals.
Once on the field, you have to push all the doors to make sure that we left no stone unturned.
Once inspectors have found a restaurant they think is review-worthy, they do some homework, researching the chef's background, the direction in which the chef is taking their cuisine, and what emotions they're trying to portray in the dishes. Then the inspectors make a reservation, under a fake name. Anonymity is sacred to Michelin. It's how the inspectors remain independent and maintain their credibility. Inspectors draw as little attention to themselves as possible as they're guided to their table. Once seated, they ask only a few questions. A simple, "What do you suggest?" to the waiter can be the extent of the conversation. What an inspector orders is completely up to them, but they always get 3 courses, an appetizer, entree, and dessert. They'll often pick the restaurant's specialty dish and any menu item that shows off the chef's real skills. The inspectors base their review on 5 long-standing criteria: quality of products, mastery of flavor and cooking techniques, the personality of the chef represented in the dining experience, value for the money, and consistency between inspectors' visits. That same criteria is used for every single Michelin review in the world, from white tablecloth to eateries to alleyway food stalls. Throughout the meal, most inspectors take notes of their finding. That used to be done with pen and paper. Now it's on their smartphone.
They try to remember everything, but today you can also use your cell phone like anyone.
They even take pictures of the dishes, which are posted on social media, and also used as a reference when it's time to write the review later on. Once a meal is thoroughly examined, the inspector pays the bill and leaves, without a trace. Normally, inspectors don't visit the same place twice, but before a restaurant wins or loses a star, Michelin will send 2 or more different inspectors to confirm their colleagues' reviews. Once a year, all the inspectors from a region get together to discuss each review. It's called the Star Meeting, and it's where they decide which restaurants are worthy of the culinary world's most coveted award. Even a 1-star rating requires a unanimous vote. Michelin's star system has been the same since 1936. One star means a very good restaurant. That's worth a stop. Two stars mean excellent cooking. That's worth a detour. And three stars? Exceptional cuisine. Worth a special journey. And the inspectors making these gastronomic decisions don't take their responsibility lightly.
At the end of the day, the Michelin Guide is working for the customer. We are here to share recommendations. So we have to come again and again to the same place, and based on that, may share a reliable recommendation saying this place is worth 1, 2, or 3 stars.
As for us, our mouths are watering, dreaming of what could be the world's tastiest profession.